I'm here for OTELCO to tell you about some exciting changes we're making to our cable network in Alabama. But first, a little bit about the company. In Alabama, OTELCO consists of Hopper Telephone, Aniana Telephone, Brindley Mountain Telephone, and Bluntsville Telephone. All of these companies, as well as our service areas in Maine, Massachusetts, Missouri, Vermont, and West Virginia, were founded by local farmers and businessmen at the dawn of the telephone industry when the larger phone companies couldn't make a business case to invest in rural America. Then the goal was communication through telephone. Today, our goal is providing internet connectivity. Our original cable TV network has been adapted over the years to deliver internet, but admittedly, there is room for improvement. By employing cutting-edge DOCSIS 3.1 technology, our network will provide download speeds that rival fiber optic internet and allow us to look at ways to enhance our cable TV offerings as well. As I mentioned, we've been around for a long time. We pride ourselves on our tradition of in-house local customer care and support, and a tradition of innovation as we continually work to improve our infrastructure to bring you better service. In the case of our cable network, DOCSIS 3.1 is the way to go. Now that I've given you some OTELCO background, let's talk about the evolution of coax cable and how DOCSIS technology has revolutionized internet delivery, and a quick lesson in Internet 101. The first thing we should talk about is the difference between an analog and a digital signal, because that is a significant element to this upgrade. We currently deliver our TV offerings in both analog and digital, but the analog element limits capacity of both TV offerings and internet speed. In order to employ the DOCSIS 3.1 technology, we must convert at least 54 of our 70 TV channels to digital only. And here's why. Analog transmission uses electrical waves to transfer sound and video. The earliest versions of DOCSIS technology allowed for digital transmission of data over coax cable, but not nearly at the bandwidth that the latest version is capable of. By converting 54 of the channels to all digital, we quadruple the capacity of the coax, allowing us to employ the DOCSIS 3.1 technology and potentially increase our digital channel lineup. Let's talk numbers. Right now, with our current technology, we can deliver download bandwidth between 5 and 25 megabits per second, and those speeds depend on your location and distance from the signal regeneration points on our network. Going with DOCSIS 3.1 will deliver residential download speeds ranging from 100 megabits per second to 1 gigabit. That means that your data will travel at least 10 times faster than it does today. Bandwidth, upload, download, internet speed, data. Here's the Internet 101 part. What's the difference between bandwidth and data? Data is anything you send or receive over the internet, and bandwidth is the size of the pipe that the data travels through. Think of a water pipe. The bigger the pipe's diameter, the more water that can pass through. The capacity of a water pipe is measured in gallons per minute, while the capacity of an internet connection is measured in amounts of data per second. So, 5 megabits per second means that it takes 1 second for 5 megabits of data to travel through the pipe. We'll talk more about data in a minute, but for now, it's important to understand that bandwidth refers to the size of your pipe. Now we'll tackle upload versus download. This is probably the easiest concept. Anything you send to the internet is upload. So, emails, files, photographs, your voice, and video when Skyping or FaceTiming. Anything that comes to you from the internet is download. Streaming video entertainment, receiving emails and other files, audio and video from the person you're Skyping with. There are many activities that require both upload and download at the same time, like gaming, video chatting, and smart home devices like Alexa and others. All of these activities combined are why the size of the pipe is so important. Here are the most common uses of internet and the amount of bandwidth they require. Any single activity isn't a big deal, but when many are happening at the same time, it can really add up. As a matter of fact, according to telecompetitor.com, data over internet usage in the average households increased by 25% from 2017 to 2018 due to things like the addition of new devices and streaming more content and higher definition content. It's important to do a periodic assessment of the devices in your home to make sure your pipe is big enough. At OTELCO, we say technology, tradition, together. We've talked about the first two, now it's time to talk about together. We've been working on this upgrade for over a year, and while we'd like to tell you it's all finished, the truth is that we need your help. Most of you have equipment in your homes, and that needs to be upgraded too. It boils down to this. If you have cable internet with us, you may need to upgrade your modem. If you do need a modem upgrade, we will contact you and make arrangements for the change. If you have either analog or digital TV, there may be some changes in equipment that you'd like to make. Let's go through the different scenarios. If you don't have a set-top box in your home, but have our cable TV services, you're an analog TV subscriber. We will be reducing your channel lineup to the 16 most popular stations. Remember, we need to do that to free up space for the increased internet capacity. We will also reduce your bill by $9 per month. You do have the option to get a set-top box and keep the full 70 channels. The rental fee for each set-top box is $6 per month, but we'll waive the rental fee on one box for 6 months. If you have multiple TVs and want the full 70-channel lineup available on all of them, you'll need a set-top box for each one. Without the box, your additional TVs will still receive the 16-channel package. If you have at least one set-top box in your home, you are a digital subscriber. But unless you have additional set-top boxes, your additional TVs get the 70 channels from an analog signal. If you do nothing, additional TVs without set-top boxes will receive the reduced 16-channel lineup. If you want the full 70 on those additional TVs, you'll need to add set-top boxes. We're offering the same special for you too. The rental fee on one additional box will be waived for 6 months. If you are a cable internet subscriber, regardless of whether you subscribe to a TV package, you may need a new modem. If you're one of those who need a new modem, we'll let you know and make arrangements to get it to you and provide a way for you to return the old one. This equipment is simple to self-install. For you digital TV subscribers, contact us if you'd like to order additional set-top boxes. We'll get them to you along with self-install instructions. If you are one of our analog cable TV subscribers and you want more than the reduced channel lineup, give us a call and we'll get the boxes to you with self-install instructions. This is a lot of information to absorb. Here are the highlights. We're bringing you super fast internet download speeds ranging from 100 megabits per second up to 1 gigabit per second. Some cable internet subscribers need to swap out their modems. We'll let you know who you are and make the appropriate arrangements for your self-install. Analog television customers are encouraged but not forced to move to digital to maintain the full channel lineup. Digital TV subscribers can add set-top boxes to additional TVs in order to maintain the full 70-channel lineup. And last but not least, there are many money-saving double and triple play bundles to consider. Call customer care at 1-833-OTELCO-1. That's 1-833-683-5261 to make sure you're set up to get the speed you need. By the way, if you're not currently an OTELCO subscriber but are interested in our service, we'd love to hear from you too.